We need
common sense.
Common sense.
Common sense.
Common sense.
Common sense.
Common sense.
Gun safety laws.
But lucky for America, I'm reporting from Common Sense, California, where the state government is famous for successfully, efficiently, and expertly solving pressing problems. Like, did you know California has the highest grade in the country from gun control advocates? They have a perfect grade A from Gabby Gifford's Law Center, where Biden's Waco-affiliated ATF appointment is an advisor. They say California has the strongest gun laws in the U.S. That's right. In proactive, progressive California, bad people aren't allowed to have guns. You can't buy more than one handgun in a month. Assault weapons are banned. High-capacity magazines are banned. No new generation Glocks. They're not on the list of safe guns approved for sale, which means they, along with many others, are not safe and thus very illegal. Very scary, very bad guns. The all-wise California government goes out of its way to keep guns out of the hands of known aggressors with track records of violence. To be sure of this, everyone has to wait 10 days for a background check, in which time a stalker could show up to your house and rape and kill you. Only peaceful, trustworthy people in good mental health, as identified by the government of California, are allowed to have guns. You know, like officer fondles a corpse. Officers shoot up a woman's truck because a cop who's thought to take out corrupt LAPD officers also drove a truck. Officers beat the out of Rodney King. Officers beat a mentally ill homeless person to death. Officers shoot a mentally ill homeless person to death. Officer brutalize a jaywalker. Officer beat a woman on the side of the road. Officers murder a sleeping man in his car because he had a gun in his lap. Officer shoot a teenage boy in the back. Officer beat down a kid for a blunt wrap. And officer rape multiple women. That's right, in California, the big, bad, scary, dangerous guns are illegal for everyone, except for cops, who enjoy the special privilege and freedom of owning off-roster guns. They're exempt from the ban on high-capacity magazines and the 10-day waiting period, because they're just doing their jobs. The California authorities don't think us peasants can be trusted to own certain guns, but their henchmen, police with long-standing track records of misconduct, corruption, assault, and murder, which the state's attorney general fought to keep secret, can definitely be trusted exclusively with the most dangerous guns of all. In fact, twice in the last 4 years, the California government has expanded the number of agencies that get to tote ruling-class guns, despite the state's pervasive record of police brutality. And guess what some of the cops do with these special gun rights? Sell the guns illegally, of course, just like they do with those banned drugs that somehow still crop up on the streets. But at least we're safe from gun violence, right? Except for the Santa Barbara shooting, the San Bernardino shooting, the LAX shooting, the synagogue shooting, the Thousand Oaks shooting, the Orinda shooting, the Gilroy Garlic Festival shooting, the Fresno shooting, and the countless other shootings that don't count as mass shootings. Not to mention the fact that the majority of gun deaths in America are suicides, not homicides. Despite California's grade A, it has failed to so much as keep guns out of the hands of people they decree can't have them, let alone stop gun violence. On that note, the same California Attorney General who attempted to hide data on police misconduct then tried to keep gun violence data secret and has since been promoted to Biden's head of Health and Human Services. Despite all the heavily praised gun control in California, mass shootings continue. And gun violence in general also skyrocketed amid Lord Newsom's very wise lockdowns, which impoverished people and destroyed mental health, driving people to desperation without stopping COVID. Much of this recent violence has been committed by gangs. That's right, cops need these big special guns, even in heavily gun-controlled states, to stop gang violence. The same gangs that have grown in power and scope due to the government's failed war on drugs, which continues today. Wait, California has strong background checks and gun laws. How are criminals getting guns? That's illegal and not allowed? How did this degenerate in California get 1,000 guns to sell illegally? Like, don't you remember when the government banned alcohol and drugs and sex work and abortion? And alcohol and drugs and sex work and abortions disappeared forever? Come on, America, take it from California, which has a higher rate of police killings than those uncivilized places like Texas, Florida, Tennessee, Kentucky, Georgia, North Carolina, South Carolina, and Alabama. Ugh, those states are so primitive. Trust me, you can definitely trust the government to correctly identify who's worthy of big, scary gun ownership. To those demanding more gun control, what happened to BLM and defunding the police? Do you think tasking cops with enforcing gun control is going to lead to budget cuts and taking away their military weapons? Which demographic do you think the police you've been calling racist for over a year will target most? Do you not see how the same police state you were outraged about until Biden and the corrupt cop took power is connected to gun control? That slaves were obviously not allowed to own weapons? Would you care if a Republican imposed gun control in a bipartisan effort to weaken the Black Panthers' resistance and police accountability efforts? What if Southern states banned Black gun ownership via the Black Codes and the Klan enforced it? Could you just try to imagine a situation in which the very minorities you claim to care about might need a gun, an AR-15 even? This isn't to say all cops are killers, though many are, and the job is inherently violent, but that standard gun control policy exacerbates the lopsided balance of abuse of power. As it happens, this hypocritical policy of guns for me, but not for thee, is pervasive in many states. Despite the fact that state and federal governments would fail their own background checks, as would all governments, as a rule, repeatedly throughout history, they characteristically initiate violence and often do so savagely with the weapons of war you think only they should be allowed to have. Meanwhile, the authoritarians in DC and the states are always surrounded by men with guns and send them to enforce their rules, including gun control. Unless those of you demanding gun control plan to personally go door to door door to enforce it. So what's the real lesson from California? Gun control is not effective at stopping violence, nor does it oppose guns. It is necessarily a concentration of violent authority and firepower in the hands of people with proven track records of abuse, and whose glorification in culture contributes far more to America's violence problem than the natural right to self-defense, which the state of California and others want to deny to you while arming themselves to the teeth. If you want gun control, you don't want to ban guns. You just want agents of the heavily documented worst institution to have a monopoly on them. You might want to think that over before you go calling on those men with guns to go stripping millions of peaceful people of their right to defend themselves in the name of defending nonviolence, peace, and life.